If you're eating oysters, do you need to eat liver too? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Anonymous says, in past posts, I believe you have said that Oystermax should be paired with liver because Oystermax is higher in zinc and liver is higher in copper. However, looking at the nutritional facts on the container for Oystermax, each serving of Oystermax is 29% of the daily value for zinc and 32% of the daily value for copper. So would you please confirm or clarify that taking Oystermax wouldn't necessarily increase the need for copper since it provides basically the same percentage of the recommended daily amount for both zinc and copper? Well, I guess, I mean, you're making a pretty strong argument that you could just take Oystermax. But I think if you just take oysters, there are other reasons to balance it with liver. For example, liver is giving you a lot more vitamin A than oysters are. And liver is higher in B vitamins. So I don't really think that makes, I think because there are many other benefits of liver that are relatively more accentuated relative to oysters, that it still makes sense to also get liver. And then the other thing is, zinc and copper might be well matched relative to the RDA, but liver is much more disproportionately a source of copper. So I guess it's a stronger argument that specifically with respect to zinc and copper, you would want to balance liver with oysters lest you get too much copper and not enough zinc. But there are still those other reasons that liver is giving you certain nutrients that oyster is probably not fulfilling all your needs for. And then the flip side of that would be if you are getting liver, that's providing you much more copper than zinc. And so I do think that's, you know, at that point, it does become relevant to say you probably need more zinc than you're getting from the liver and a reason to put the Oystermax in. Another way to look at this would be relative to the RDA is one thing, but relative to your individual copper needs might be another. And so if you are doing, for example, blood testing and your copper levels are specifically low and your zinc levels are not, then I actually think liver is a better thing to increase than oyster because oyster is so high in zinc that a lot of that copper is going to be chelated. So if your zinc levels are very, very good and you increase zinc even further, you will sort of make that copper less potent, whereas liver is going to really jack up the copper relative to zinc and is a much better thing to include if you're specifically trying to correct a copper deficiency. I would also note that oysters are going to vary from batch to batch in their zinc to copper ratio. And I think oysters are more reliably a source of zinc relative to copper and relative to liver. And liver is much more consistently a source of copper relative to zinc and relative to oysters. And so I kind of stand by what I said in terms of taking into account the variation in different species of oyster in different oceans and different batches of oyster products. But Oystermax does batch testing. And so what I answered you in this particular answer, would be my answer for when you know that the batch of oyster you're getting has roughly equal zinc and oyster. So thank you, Anonymous, for your question. Hope that helped. This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.